Okay, Namit, I have started the recording. You can start now.
Hello, this is Namit Jain. So today we will be covering a topic on Mocky Source Management Guide and ID Setup.
Namit, sorry to interrupt. Will you please do a little bit of zoom in here on browser and also on the IDE front? I would recommend to increase the font size. A little zoom in.
Sure. I actually already did to 125%. Now is it okay?
It's better now. Yeah.
150. Okay, perfect.
So same when you go to IDE, please make sure that you increase the font size there as well.
Yes.
Okay? Yeah, please. Thank you.
Yeah. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
sir. So in today's session, we'll be covering topic on source management guide and IDE setup. So if we have gone through our previous session on introduction to Mocky by Deepak, he already mentioned a very how we means what all repositories, what all application we already have, what all tools we already have in business artifacts which we can use to develop our own application. So we have seen all that previously in our sessions. So today we will see how we can manage these repositories using the Mocky tool only. So repositories, Mocky framework and Mocky runtime, are the two repositories which resides in a structure where Mocky framework is at the top and it contains a runtime directory. Rest all the components which
sorry to interrupt once again, but I would recommend to update the theme to the light one instead of using this one. Yeah, actually that theme helps us in better visibility here. So you need to go to settings. Yes. Appearance. Yeah. No, third. Yeah. Yes, perfect. And I think font size is good, so yeah, you can go from there. Yeah. Thank you, Namit.
Sure. So yeah, we have means all the custom or the existing Mocky tools and applications which are already provided in the repository are which are actually added in the component folder of runtime directory. This is the structure which is required to be followed. All the repositories is available in hosted.github, where you can find all the required applications which are needed for developing your custom application. There are around 34 existing repositories in this. You'll find all the PopCommerce, HiveMind, and the business artifact, all the business artifacts. Coming back to the topic, where to maintain all these repositories, it is required to configure an add-on.xml file. So if we go back to the code, you can see there's a file name add-on.xml which resides under root folder of Mocky. Here we define all the add-ons or the components with the repository structure. So by default, if we can see, the add-on has attribute named default repository, which says GitHub. So if we go inside this add-on structure, we can find multiple repositories. So it says there is a repository named GitHub, which has some location type saying current release binary and Git. So if you're using a Git repository, it will having a .git file. So based on that, it defines, like if you don't define the location type, then this by default Git current is actually used. If it has already .git file, then the GitHub .git file is used. So basically, if we see this whole file, you'll find all different type of repositories where we have git.ssh, Bitbucket, Bitbucket.ssh, and Bitbucket token. So basically here, what we have defined is the path of the repository with the with defined structure. Next, we have a runtime directory where runtime attribute where we define the default runtime component. Rest all the components are defined here, like example Mocky, AWS Mocky Camel, Mocky Cups, and all. So where it is used, how it is used, we will be covering it later. So all these components are already defined here. We can also define a component set, and if we want like framework to be set up. So in this framework, we have example, Mocky, AWS, and all this are predefined over here. So whenever we use Gradle command to actually set up a component, we can just define which component set need to be set up. So if we ask for framework, it will actually set up all these component inside it. So just go back and let's take a look how it works. So as I just mentioned that Mocky provide you internal management to manage the component with the if it is in deployed on Git, so we can we have the option to clone, or we have the option to pull get status and also upstream that product. So there are certain set of Gradle tasks already defined in Mocky which we can use. So if you want us, if you go into runtime components and pop commas, and if you run this, we can see that for origin we have set this this two URLs for the pop commas. If we want to set upstream, we just need to add it to remote, and here is something kind of URL we need to make sure is we just copy over here. We just need to add the repository URL. And we just need to add git remote add upstream and add this repository URL. And when we add it, and we, if we try to see the version, we can see for upstream we have a git repository for pop commas. So whenever we fetch or push or whenever we will be doing upstream using git, using a git command, git upstream all, or git upstream pull, during that time it will be checking the upstream and will be merging all this, all the new changes into the fork repository. So this is how you actually manage repositories for the Mocky using the Gradle commands which are already existing in the Gradle toolset. So any questions, any queries regarding this till yet? Okay, so moving to the next topic regarding the IDE setup. So basically, in today we will be actually covering the for IntelliJ only. Everyone has its own preferences to set up a project in its machine, on its system, or on its IDE. But Mocky provides certain certain rules or recommendations from its side. Whenever you start a project or from the beginning, These have certain configuration which you can keep it on your side to fully use Mocky in fully functional way. So I have already added a Mocky framework on the directory structure. I'm going to set up it on my IDE. So this is basically I'm using IntelliJ for setting up a Mocky project. So in to set up a project, we just need to go to File, then New. Here you can see a project from existing resource. So if we if we click on this, basically it asks for a directory structure which need to be set up. So for Mocky project, we need to actually set up the Mocky root folder. So we are using this Mocky project root framework root folder and click on the OK. So in this section, we are asked to create a project from existing resource and import a project from external model. So we already have application in our system. So we are using import project from external model, and we select this. We have multiple options. In this, we are using Gradle, as we are using Gradle in our Mocky project. So we will be using Gradle for setting up of the project. So when we select this Gradle and click on Finish, it will actually set up the Mocky project for the system. Mocky will actually build the application for the system based on the Gradle settings. We already have built out Gradle on the root structure, so it takes this Gradle file to actually run and build the application for the first time. So we just make sure we have a proper setup of Gradle in the system, and it will work. So this is the first setting which is required to be done. Next, we just need to make sure, like we have seen like we have multiple XSD files which we need to set. We use Mocky, we can get all the definitions by IntelliSense.
Hi, so, Namit. Hello. Namit, sorry to interrupt, but yes. Your voice was cranking up for around 10 seconds or so. So, will you please repeat that one? Last 10 to 15 seconds.
Sure. So, I was just discussing about. We already have means we just XSD discussed XSD. About yes I just have discussed about setting up a Mocky project using the Gradle files on the IntelliJ IDE. To actually use Mocky in fully fledged way, we have some XSDs because we are using Minilang over here. So if in order to use all the XSDs, get all the definitions, all that in our IntelliSense, so that IntelliJ can suggest to us, we need to set up XML schemas. So to do that, we can just set up the URLs which are used, the namespace which are used in the code with the local set of files which we already have in the framework component. So to do that, what we can do here is we can just go into the settings. In under settings, we have language and framework where we have schemas and DTDs. So I have already set up some of the XSD file over here. So what we just did here is I use the URLs of mocky.org.xsd pointed it to the location which is in the framework XSD folder. So if we just click add, and we just need to add the URL over here and the respectively file for that. So we can just go into Mocky framework. In framework, we have XSGs. So all these XSGs are already listed over here. If we just want to use that XSGs, we can configure from this external resource. We can map it in this external resource. So this is one setting which you need to make sure to be done while using Mocky. Then for language injection for Mocky and XML, we can if we have script tags. So basically, script tags, we want it to be in script tags we add the Groovy code. So if we wanted to map it with Groovy from the XML, we can follow the steps. So basically, what we need to do here is we just need to go into the settings. Under settings, we have the editor option. In editor option, we have the language injection option. So if we want to add our custom script tag for Groovy, we just need to click add. Here we have XML tag injection. We can use this XML tag injection, give a custom name like script for Groovy. And we can just define the tags, like we have script tag, and leaving all the setting as it is, and click the OK button, then apply. It will actually apply all the script tags to be read from Groovy. So this is how you can manage your IntelliJ or your IDE to basically full use the Mocky in full-fledged way. It will provide all the this is basically how you can set up. These are basic recommendations. You can have your custom settings and control settings to use Mocky or any project you want to set up on IDE. So this is all regarding the IntelliJ setup. Any questions regarding any of the items which we discussed earlier? So this is all from my side.
Yeah, well, I think yes, this is it. So thank you so much, Namit, for this helpful sessions. I'm sure it will help all the developers in setting up their projects and utilizing the already available configurations in Mocky. And also thanks to all the